In this programme, we have deliberately not dwelt on the many problems of the British motor industry. But Motor Fair has thrown up yet another market segment where the traditional British supremacy suddenly looks very vulnerable indeed. Reporting from the front line, here's Richard.
As much a hero of the Second World War as John Wayne, the Jeep, the pioneer of the small four-wheel drive car, the original quarter-ton general purpose, and that's how it got its name, GP, Jeep.
And now the Jeep is making another invasion attempt. It's attacking the British horse box and holiday market for four-wheel drive cars. But it's not quite the same now as it was in 1940. Power steering, air conditioning, automatic transmission. Today, all the power and comfort of a big American V8, the Cherokee. And not just automatic transmission, quadratrack they call it, a four-wheel drive that automatically makes sure the power goes to the wheels with the most grip. This is one of a whole pack of new Jeeps attacking our market. But what are the Americans doing here, in the home of the Land Rover and the Range Rover? Last year, nearly every one of the 12,000 four-wheel drive vehicles sold in Britain was a Leyland Rover. Unfortunately, worldwide, there have been waiting lists. In some African countries, Leyland's share of the market has come crashing down from 3 out of 4 to barely a third. They simply couldn't make enough of them.
The competitors? Inevitably, the Japanese, with the Toyota Land Cruiser, for example. But there's a new one in Britain for Motor Fair, the Daihatsu. More agricultural and stiffly sprung, the Daihatsu's little engine still gives it a lively turn of speed. There's a high range of gears for main road cruising and a low range for the hills with four-wheel drive too. At the price, it's carving out a whole new market. So Land Rover and Range Rover matched in the £5,500 to £9,500 market with the Jeep and undercut by the basic Daihatsu. The importers, who already have the UK concession for BMW, believe Leyland have had the home market too easy. With the wait for a Rover, anything up to a year, they say Britain is undersupplied by 15 to 20%. And General Motors are here too with the Blazer Cheyenne for Indian country in the stockbroker belt. No plodding diesel under the bonnet, instead another vast V8, 6.7 litres and power everything. The windows are electric, of course. A tall car with a big bill for the off-road leisure motorist. The civilian end of what is, of course, a very large market indeed. In fact, we know there are yet more vehicles of this type on their way to Britain shortly. In fact, this one's just arrived since we started a few minutes ago on the item. Like father, like son? Well, there's certainly a strong family resemblance, isn't there? But what are Leyland doing about all this? They're spending £250 million to double their production. But the question is, have they already missed the four-wheel drive bus?